Hey guys, Brian Schultz here with Actually Tiny, and for the last week in the shop here, I've been working on this coffee table that had some integrated storage in it. Now, the important thing about building any piece of furniture for a tiny house is you want it to do as many jobs as possible. Now, this coffee table is at a perfect height for sitting on top of. Obviously, it can also be used as a coffee table. I've got some storage compartments built in here, but I thought it also might be cool if I could make the top of this pop up a little bit higher so I could use it as a writing or a computer desk as well. Now, fortunately, they make brackets that are perfect for this. They look like this. They're only about $25, and they mount on the inside of the cabinet and the underside of the table and extend upwards with either springs or pneumatic lifters like this one right here. Now, the only downside of these is that because the top and the bottom surface isn't perfectly parallel, they can be a little bit tricky to install. And also, when they're raised all the way up with a really heavy tabletop like this one right here, they can be a little bit wobbly from side to side. Now, fortunately, both of these problems are really easy to solve. You don't need to go up to the next level of much more expensive brackets. So I'm going to walk you through the installation process right here, and then when we're all done, we'll check it out and see how it works. So first thing you need to know is that if you're going to be installing a lifting tabletop, you've got to make your base cabinet really strong because the tabletop's not going to be integrated into it. The next thing is just to make sure you leave the right amount of space for the bracket. Now this particular bracket I think is 13¾ long by about 4 inches tall, but I would leave yourself at least 14 by 4¼ inches in here to be able to install this. All right, so first thing I'm gonna do is put the tabletop on top of the cabinet, and we're gonna collapse this hinge and physically hold it in place on the outside, underside here, and we're gonna use that to get our marks for our fastener locations. And this is really 90% of the battle of this particular installation. Now, just because we're marking this on the outside doesn't mean that we're going to end up installing it on the outside. We're actually gonna switch the hinges later and put them on the inside here. It's just so much easier to mark it from the outside. So let's go ahead and collapse this hinge. I'm gonna hold this up underneath the coffee table right here. I'm gonna move it back a little bit from the front edge. In this case, I went back about 1/2 inch. And now I can go ahead and clamp this with some spring clamps to the bottom of my coffee table. This can be a little bit frustrating because it wants to spring open on you, but if you can get it to this point, you can take another clamp right in here and you can clamp both of these legs. And now you can see that it's holding itself in place, and that's what we want. Now, next thing I'm gonna do is take a pencil and very, very accurately mark the center of each of these mounting holes. I can see two mounting holes in the front and one mounting hole in the back here, and that's gonna give me enough to where I can align this bracket. So once I've got these marks, I can go ahead and take the bracket out of the way. I'm gonna push the tabletop out of the way. And then I'm gonna take this extended bracket right here and I'm gonna hold it back on those marks and use that to find my final mark, which is gonna be in this hole here that was covered when the bracket was collapsed. Now, it's super important that these holes are marked really accurately right in the center of the bracket holes, because the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pilot down the center of these, and you can do one of two things from there. You can either just pilot all the way through, and then you can use that as your pilot hole for a screw fastener from the inside, or you can do what I'm gonna show you to do here today, which is to make a series of larger holes that we're gonna put some T-nuts in, and then those are gonna be paired with some socket head cap screws that are gonna really hold this bracket tightly to the cabinet. So either way, at this point, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna back the inside of this with a piece of scrap plywood, and that's gonna keep these holes from splintering out on the inside. I'm gonna start with a 1/16-inch drill bit, and I'm gonna drill straight through each one of these holes. Now, it's really important to make sure that you're drilling perfectly straight through your board here so these fasteners are gonna be in the same location on the inside. Now, like I just said, I'm going to be attaching this bracket with some 1/4-20 socket cap machine screws here that are gonna be going into some 1/4-inch T-nuts here. Now, these 1/4-inch T-nuts have a 5/16 outside diameter. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work my way up through different sizes of drill bits until I get to a 5/16-inch hole, making sure that I'm drilling nice and straight with each successive size of drill bit. All right, so these holes are a little bit chewed up on the outside, but that's fine because we're gonna be covering that with T-nuts. What's important is that they're nice and clean on the inside. And I'm gonna go ahead and push the T-nuts into place here. So next thing I'm gonna do is attach the bracket with these quarter 20 socket cap screws. Now, the reason I chose this particular fastener for this is because it can be really awkward to get a driver down into a small space like this. Also, this is gonna give you a much more solid attachment if you don't mind the look of the T-nuts on the outside. Now, if you're using these quarter 20 screws here, you are gonna have to enlarge these holes in the back here. I went ahead and took a 1/17/64 drill bit and just drilled this out a little bit. For whatever reason, these ones up front are already big enough, so you don't have to worry about that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this in place, and then just really carefully, I'm gonna go ahead and screw these in. Now, most of the T-nuts that you're gonna find are gonna be round, and some of them have spikes that point inward. I actually like the ones that don't have the spikes, and these ones here are kind of unique. They have flat spots on either side, so I can use a scrap piece of wood to keep them lined up to each other while I tighten them down, which just makes it look a little bit neater. Now, these particular T-nuts are kind of a nice metallic gray, which I think looks pretty good with this particular cabinet, but oftentimes T-nuts are kind of a bright silver zinc, and what you can do to darken those is just dip them in some gun bluing acid, and it'll turn them nice and dark, kind of makes them match the furniture, I think, a little bit better. Now, another thing I want to mention really quick is that I kind of messed up here. I meant to drill these two holes right here, and instead I did these two. It's not a huge difference. I just feel like the closer you are to this hinge point, the better it stabilizes this bracket. All right, so we've got the brackets installed here. They operate nice and cleanly. They're perfectly level to the top surface of the tabletop here. Now let's go ahead and address the other big issue with these, and that is dealing with the fact that if you put a heavy tabletop on this, like we're going to, it's gonna wanna wobble from side to side. Now, the solution for this isn't perfect. There's still gonna be a little bit of wobble, but it's gonna be a lot better than it was. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take two blocks of 1/2-inch plywood that are sanded down to be just a little bit thinner, and I'm gonna put these behind the metal supports right here, so as the tabletop wants to push sideways, it actually has something to push against, and it's not gonna be nearly as wobbly. So come on in here and we'll show you how to mount these. All right, so this piece of wood is about 8 inches long by about 2 inches tall here. I've gone ahead and clamped it on the inside, and I've gone ahead and piloted and countersunk for some screws. I'm just gonna go ahead and take a couple number 6 screws and screw this in place. And I can take my clamps off. And the important thing about this is that as this comes back like this, there has to be enough wood here to stay on this portion of the bracket right here so it doesn't catch as it's trying to come up like that. Once again, these are about 8 inches long by about 2 inches tall. And you can really fine tune the thickness of these so there's very little play back and forth between your brackets once you mount your tabletop. Let's go ahead and do that right now. So I've got the tabletop sitting on top here, nice and square. Now I'm gonna go ahead and reach in and I'm just gonna mark all the way around the flange for this bracket right here. So now you can go ahead and slide your tabletop off and raise the brackets up, put the tabletop back on, line everything up on the marks that you just made, and then you can get underneath here and really carefully pilot and put a couple of small pan head screws in. I would recommend just putting a couple small screws in and then checking to make sure that the whole thing operates cleanly before you commit to really fastening this thing down. All right, so that's pretty much it for installing these lift top hinges right here. I'm gonna go ahead and open this up one last time so you can see how stiff this is. This is a huge difference from when I first mocked this up. Those brackets were just wobbling all over the place. So these little wooden blocks that we added here are a huge improvement. Now, the only real downside of installing this kind of a hinge is that this tabletop slopes a little bit downwards. So if you need something that you can put a marble in the middle of and it's not gonna move, you're gonna have to go to the much more expensive style of hinge. Now, the other thing is that when you lift this up and down, you do have to lift from both sides at the same time, because if you just try to lift from one side like that, it just kind of twists and it doesn't really work out very well. But other than that, pretty happy with how this went together. Really looking forward to using it in the tiny house. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. You can also find us on our website, actuallytiny.com, where we've got a growing library of tiny house resources and more free tiny house building videos. You can also check us out on Instagram at actuallytiny, where we've got a daily build blog of everything that we do on the tiny house, including time-lapse videos. All right, that's it for now. Take care, be safe, and have fun building your tiny house.